In this video, we're going to look at vendor GL groups. Now, if you recall from AP, when you go to set up a vendor, on the additional information tabs, they have GL groups. These GL groups are what are set up. You don't have to have them on the vendor. But what it does is, by creating a GL group, when you create a transaction in purchasing, it'll automatically code the GL account that belongs to that vendor in the purchasing transaction. So it serves a useful data entry purpose that keeps you from making data errors, basically, and makes it easier to put the information in. Now, you also have groups, which are your vendor groups, not to be confused with GL groups. These groups are the same groups as you created in AP for your vendors, so you can sort them by specific criteria. Like in this case, we have vendors. I love how I misspelled that. I wouldn't bother to call that out. Vendors, which flow through from AP. So just allows you to do dynamic pulling of reports and things of that nature. That's the GL groups and the groups for vendors.